This is Sleepy Rainforest Friends with Mrs. Orendorf.
Hey friends, welcome back. This is Mrs. Orendorf. This is a lesson for a sleepy sloth or rainforest friend. We are going to be making a rainforest friend, either a raccoon, a koala, or a sloth. One of the artists that inspired this lesson was Henry Rousseau. Go look him up. There's a lot of cool information about his art and his style. So grab a pencil, a paper, an eraser, and step number one, always write your name on your paper. Let's get started. Today I'm going to show you how to paint the background for our beautiful sloth painting. This is what we're going by. This is one of the examples that my students drew. We have the raccoon. We also have the koala. Some of them even chose to make a little baby on top. So today I'm just gonna show you how to do the ombre effect for the background. I gave them a choice to do either greens for the rainforest or blues like a night scene. Okay, so here, we started, and yes, believe it or not, this sloth, very simple lines and shapes, that was part one of the lesson to draw with lines and shapes, is going to be this cutie patootie, this very texturized sloth. But we take it one step at a time. I'm going to begin. I'm going to mix just a little bit of lime green. The yellow is to lighten up my base color. And if it's a little too thick, you can always dip your brush in a little bit of water to make it more liquidy, and this will help it flow better. So I'm going to start from the edge of the head and pull out. And I told my students, it's sort of like a tie-dye effect. Okay, it's okay if you get it a little bit on the sloth or your animal, whatever you drew, and on the branches, all of that is going to get painted over. So don't worry about perfection at this point. We are focusing on the radiating effect of the background. Now that I have done the basic first color, which is the lime green, and it radiates from the center out like a sun, now we are going to add a second layer about 3 fingers or so with my regular green. Now, sometimes it's hard to create an ombre effect where the colors blend in. Here you see a little more rough edge, then that's okay, that's pretty too. And this one is very, very soft. Do you see the blending? You can still tell. Once you know the steps, you can kind of tell where those are. So with regular green, I'm going to start from here and then pull in like this, like you're combing hair, and then very lightly tap my brush over the lime green. If you have a very hard line, what you can do is you dip your brush in just a little bit of water, and then you go over those 2 overlapping colors with a little bit of water, and that softens up your blending edge. You see that? Okay, so I'm going to reload my brush with a little bit of green and then move over here. Again, we are going for that radiating effect, like sun rays, except this time they are green. And then if you have a hard line, while it's still wet, get your brush a little bit wet and then go over that area. Okay, you can keep rotating your paper, or you can work from other angles. I like to rotate my paper because that gives me that sun ray effect. Okay, now I'm dipping my brush in a little bit of water and I'm going over that middle ground where the 2 colors meet. Mix just a little bit of green with a little bit of, about that much green, and just a little corner of my brush with black. Need a whole lot. And I'm going to work on my corners. That gives you depth. and we are going to let it dry. And then we're gonna come back with a little bit of yellow. If you have the night scene with the blue, you can do yellow or you can do white dots for the stars in the distance in the sky. Now that the green is dry, we are ready for the tree trunk. Here I have some regular brown. That's my base color for the tree branch. And then I have a little bit of black for shadow and then a lighter color for highlight. You can use tan or you can use a little bit of white. So I'm going to, again, I'm going with a flat head brush. I'm going to paint my trunk or my branch, whatever you drew your little animal on. Yes, you can paint over your Sharpie line. The Sharpie line was just there to guide you, but it's not necessary to keep it showing. Now, I notice here I missed that little part between the two branches, which I will fill in with a little bit of lime green. Okay, and I am just painting solid. Notice how I'm holding my brush like this flat. You can also use it like this, sort of like a little broom. That gives you that nice thick line. And if you need to get skinny, then you use it like this, straight up and down. Notice how I'm not leaving lumps of paint on my paper. If you leave big lumps of paint, they dry in little clumps and then they chip off your paper. And that's not good. Also, if you leave any white showing like this, like I'm done, and you can still see what the white paper under it. No, you are not done. You need to go over it again, nice and smooth, and make sure that everything is covered up. Okay, now I'm ready for my shadow. I'm going to mix a little bit of darker brown with just the little corner of the black. Remember how we mixed? Or you can just use a little corner of the black over the brown. And I'm going to start basically near the edges of my branch. Okay, just some lines. You know how tree trunks, tree branches, they have a rough bark. So it doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be even. Okay, I'm gonna put some on here. And I'm not covering all the brown. I'm just putting some hints of shadow. So now I'm going to dip my brush, same brush. I'm not going to rinse it because these colors all need to work together. I'm going to dip it in the light brown or the tan. And I'm just going to put a few lines for highlights. While this branch dries, I'm gonna do the stars in the background. I have a pointy brush. I'm going to dip it in the yellow. And I'm just gonna do a few dots in the background. The yellow doesn't look very bright, but it does get brighter as it dries. You can put them all over, okay? Like little stars in the distance. Some of them may end up getting covered up with the vines and the branches that are hanging around your animal. That's okay. It's better to have enough than to have empty spaces. Don't go super fast. If you go really fast and you just go like that, can you see the little yellow circle? No. Dip your brush, lightly tap on the paper, and make sure that you get that nice little yellow circle. If you think you are done and then you go back and you're like, oh, that one doesn't look like a circle, go over it again and do it a second time. So here I'm going to dip my brush and I'm going to start with the lightest areas first. This area here. This kind of looks like a little heart shape above his eyes. Okay, we're gonna let that dry a little bit. Rinse your brush very well, just in a little bit of water. Kind of wiggle, wiggle your brush. Get rid of your excess water on the edge of your container. There we go. And we are ready for our medium brown. The medium brown will go a little bit here. And it's very little. You want to add more. If it's too dark, you want to add a little more of that tan. And if it helps, you can put just a little bit of gray with your brown, and that will give you this nice little shadow. Now I'm dipping in the umber, and you don't need to rinse your brush. I'm just going around here, around the face, around the chin. Okay, now I'm going to add my shadow. And if you have some rough lines, remember our little trick, you dip your brush in a little bit of water and then you go over it and very gently rub your paintbrush over that area and it will blend your two colors together. Now that my paint is dry, we are ready for oil pastels. We only need a few oil pastels. I used white, brown, and just a little bit of black. The key here is how you color with the oil pastel. You want to use the oil pastel to make the hair look like hair. So notice how I'm putting my oil pastel down and I'm pulling up, just like little hairs, one at a time. I'm going to do white for highlights here at the top of my slots forehead, and then I did some brown on top of the dark brown. If the brown doesn't show up enough, maybe find a lighter brown. This one would be like a goldenrod. That's pretty, like highlights. Just make sure you don't go in the eye area. The eye area does not have fur or light fur, it's dark like this. And then I did just a little bit of black for shadow. With my black oils, I outlined the eyes, I colored in the nose very carefully. Okay, it's kind of tricky because the oils are not very friendly like color pencil. So you want to, if you color and you think I'm done, go back. If you see any white or any color under it, go back, unless it's that little light reflection that we're leaving on the nose. Everything else should be colored in and you may have to go over it a few times. And here's the mouth. Make sure that you go right over that line that you had underneath. And he's already turning out pretty cute. Now here's a little tip. If you made a very small area, like a little baby animal, instead of using oil pastel, I suggest you use a black color pencil because that will give you the smaller lines for the face details. All right, so now I'm gonna do some white on this area here. We are ready to paint our beautiful leaves. If you notice, I have two different tones within my vines. I have a medium green, and then I have a dark green. The dark green ones kind of make it look like they're in the distance. They give you depth as well. So all these little visual tricks, guys. So I have three colors. I have my medium green, and then I have some white to lighten it, and I have black to make darker green. When you mix a color with white, you are creating a tint. When you mix a color with black, you are creating a shadow. You know that? All right, we learn something new every day. Now I have here a brush, a watercolor brush, and the way that you are going to get the shape of the leaves is the way that you put the brush down on your paper, okay? We're not painting lines, we are printing with our brush on its side. That's one, two, and I could use the back of it because that also has paint, three. And if you want it a little lighter, you can add a little more white. One, two, three, and then dip again. I'm gonna use the back of my brush to go over these. There we go. And I'm going to dip it again. I wouldn't print more than three little leaves because then your brush runs out of paint. I rinse my brush in a little bit of water. It's okay if it still has some green remainder in there because we're also gonna work with, now this is too much. If you see that it gets very dark, carry over more of your regular green paint. There we go. That's a pretty good dark green. And I'm going to do this one. One, two, three. I can use the back two. There we go. Okay, dip it again. And the piece de resistance, the final details, is the flowers. Here I have some flower sponges. We dip it in the paint and print your beautiful flowers. So I'm going to gently dip this in my tempera. If it has too much, you can lightly pat it on a paper towel or another part of the paper plate, and then gently place it where you want it. Notice how these are. I placed it down and I'm gently pressing. If you press super hard, you're gonna lose the shape. And release. And if you have little air bubbles or whatever, you can always go back with a little brush and smooth it out. This paint is quite thin, so I think I'm just going to let it do its thing and leave it alone. I kind of like that texture, actually. Very cool. All right, I'm going to try the smaller one. And again, get rid of your, I got a little dot there, so I guess a flower's going there. I'm pressing down just a little bit. Ta-da! Okay, I really like that size too. So kind of spread them out. Don't make them touch so they stand out on their own. Okay, and always dip it again before you stamp another one. And they can overlap on top of your darker colors. They will stand out beautifully. If you want other colors, not just pink, you can kind of think what colors would go well together. Obviously, not cool colors, I wouldn't recommend. I would recommend something warm colors like orange, definitely pink. Red would be pretty if it's a bright red, not a crimson red necessarily, because that would just make it look darker. And keep going. Make sure, I always tell my kids, take care of your corners. Sometimes we forget about the corners. The final step is going to be with a little dot of yellow. Once my pink dries, I will put the center of my flowers. And I would do the same or very similar technique for the blue background for your koala or raccoon. All right, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. I know it was a little bit long, but it is a full painting lesson. Enjoy it, so proud of you. I'm sure your picture is going to be wonderful.